Now, Wimbledon 80, BBC One's coverage of this afternoon's matches in the Lawn Tennis Championships.
Good afternoon on this fourth day of Wimbledon in 1980. A strange day in some ways because play, as you probably know, was scheduled to start at noon today because of the tremendous backlog of matches that had built up owing to the rain on the first 2 days. Well, at noon today, I'm afraid it was raining again, and so the start was delayed by some 40 minutes, but since then we've had uninterrupted play, and we have this afternoon some really outstanding matches, many of them on these outside courts, because if you weren't with us earlier, perhaps I should explain again that on number two court, for example, where you're looking now, both the defending champions in the ladies and the men's singles championship are playing on this court this afternoon, both Bjorn Borg and Martina Navratilova. And nobody here can remember when that last happened, when the two defending champions both played on the same outside court on the same afternoon. We've got John McEnroe playing on number three, the number two seed. So on those outside courts, tremendous activity. Now let me show you what we've got in store on the two show courts. And on number one court this afternoon, there's a match in play at the moment. Currently on BBC Two between Corrado Baruzzutti of Italy and his Italian Davis Cup partner Adriano Panatta. And then Ilya Nastasi of Romania will be playing Dick Stockton of the United States. And then the number three seed in the ladies' championship, the former champion Chris Lloyd from the States, is playing the young Swiss girl Christiane Jolissin. And then Helena Anliot of Sweden faces the number seven seed from Britain, Virginia Wade. And then a men's doubles, Colin Dowdeswell and Jürgen Fassbender against the American Mayer brothers, Sandy and Jean. Now, the order of play on the centre court is as follows. Sherwood Stewart of the United States is about to come out to play Jimmy Connors of the United States. Connors, of course, the 1974 champion here. And then another seed, the number 10 seed, the young Czech Ivan Lendl, only 20 years old, is playing John Sadri from the United States. And then the 15-year-old American, Andrea Jaeger of the United States, seeded 14, is playing Martina Redondo of the United States. And finally, a men's doubles, Francisco Gonzalez and Belush Praju, is playing the number 14 seeds in the doubles, Buster Mottram and Ilya Nastasi. Now let's have a look out on court. On court 13, that is, where Mark Cox of Great Britain, who has joined us, of course, on the commentary team. Mark Cox is out there playing Ramesh Krishnan, the young Indian player. Now there's 18 years difference in age between these two. Cox will be 37 on Saturday week. And his opponent, the Indian Krishnan, is only 19, Wimbledon junior champion last year. And we can see from that that Mark Cox has won the first set on the tiebreak, and now they're four games all in the second set. Cox actually had a little bit of an altercation during the tiebreak, got a little angry over something, but he's calmed down now. Four games all in the second set. Now let's go to the centre court, because this is where we're going to concentrate now. And this is Sherwood Stewart and Jimmy Connors. First time we've had a chance to see Jimmy Connors. And the left-hander, of course, 1974 champion, runner-up three times, 27 years old now, seeded three, and playing Sherwood Stewart here, who is 34 years old, comes from Houston in Texas, and rather better known for his doubles form than his singles form. Now, the commentators on the centre court are John Barrett and Dan Maskell.
And very happy to see the former Wimbledon champion back again on the centre court, Jimmy Connors. Last time I saw him play was at in Dallas, Texas, when he had such a very fine win of that tournament, beating McEnroe in the final, 2-6, 7-6, 6-1, 6-2. And it really looked as though Connors was playing in the form that one thought, well, a few more months of hard play and he'll be right back as a serious contender for this championship. 27, born in Illinois, but now lives at Miami Beach in Florida. A lot of people don't realise that he's 5'10". Sometimes they think he's much shorter than that. Weighs 11 stone 1. He was the champion in 1974 at Wimbledon, and the runner-up in 75, 77, 78, and beaten by Borg in the semi-final last year. On the doubles here with Nastasi in 1973, so his record at Wimbledon is pretty good. A lot of people perhaps don't realise that he was the United States Open champion in 1974, 1976 and 78, and the runner-up a couple of times. Beaten in the recent French Open Championship when he was seeded number 3, beaten by Gary Lydus, who was seeded 5, 6-4 in the final set after Connors had led 2 sets to 1. His win at Wimbledon in the first round here was against Richard Lewis, Britain's number ranking 4 player, 6-love, 6-3, 6-1. I wonder if we ought to have a look at Sherwood Stewart. Sherwood Stewart is actually born at a very romantically named place, Goose Creek in Texas. Now lives in Houston in Texas. He's way back on the computer, he's 114, but of course, as you have heard, he is a far better doubles player than a singles player, but nevertheless has some very fine victories in singles to his credit. In 1977 he beat Borg at Oviedo in Spain to end Borg's winning streak of 3 straight tournaments. In 79 he beat Peter Fleming, that tall American who was such a great doubles player, and he also beat Hank Pfister. Wimbledon last year he was beaten by Victor Pecci, that very exciting player from Paraguay who was seeded 8. He lost in straight sets, and he was seeded in the doubles number 5 and beaten with Marty Reeson, his fairly regular partner, beaten in the second round by the veterans Owen Davidson and John Newcomb. Well, up in the Royal Box we have an interesting man there in the middle of your picture, Ian Botham, the England captain, who I believe, amongst his other pursuits in sport, can also play this game. Let's hope he sees a very fascinating match here. Just to once again say a little about the two players on court. They've only met once. That was in 1975, when Connors won 6-1, 6-1 in the second round of the Dewar Cup at the Royal Albert Hall in London. Well, John, Sherwood Stewart is a doubles player of, I suppose, one of the very best in the world.
Yes, he of course used to play with Fred McNair and struck up a marvellously successful partnership with him. Their great year was 76, and they won the French Open and the Grand Prix Masters, as well as the German Open, and they were runners-up together in the Italian. And it wasn't until 1978 at the US Open that he came to play with his present partner, Marty Reeson. And they reached the doubles there that year, Flushing Meadow, the first year we were at Flushing Meadow, and lost to Stan Smith and Bob Lutz in the final. And that persuaded them they should team up, and a very wise decision it was, because last year they won 8 doubles titles together on the Grand Prix circuit. And this man, Sherwood Stewart, won a couple of others, important ones. One with Thomas Smid of Czechoslovakia in Buenos Aires, and one in Houston with Gene Mayer. Houston, his hometown now. And then he went down to Australia at the end of the year, Sherwood Stewart, knowing that if he did well, or well enough, he could just sneak past John McEnroe to take the $90,000 first prize in the Grand Prix competition. That's the first doubles prize, and he did it. And so he is the current Grand Prix doubles champion. He and Reeson, I suppose, most people would consider would be the second best pair in the world on their record, behind, of course, McEnroe and Fleming, the current Wimbledon champions and US Open champions, of course. Virtually unassailable, though I remember, Dan, when we were talking about that at Queen's Dub, they went and lost. So you can't be right all the time.
Well, I think we ought to say that Stewart, of course, played quite well in the singles at Queen's just a couple of weeks before Wimbledon. Lost to Gary Lytus, who was seeded number 2, 7-5, 6-3, so he's not short of grass court practice.
Jimmy Connors at this end, of course, at a fairly critical moment in his career, and he's showing signs of revitalization, if that's the right word. This year he's showing much better form again, but by critical I mean he's been overtaken at the top of the American rankings by John McEnroe, quite correctly on form, and I think he was perhaps smarting a little inwardly from that. And they're very, very closely matched. They've both had wins against one another this year. And of course, Connors won the WCT title against McEnroe. Fairly decisive moment. Well, how nice to see this crowd basking in welcome sunshine. First set, Stewart to serve.
Love, 15. Love, 30. Love, 40. Right. First service. Connors, first game. Some early results, and there, Billie Jean King, the number five seed, just before you came to us, on the centre court, had beaten Anne Smith of the United States, 6-4, 7-6. And the number 11 seed in the ladies, Greer Stevens of South Africa, has beaten Paula Smith of the States, 6-1, 6-4. Lindsay Morse of the United States has beaten Kathy Teacher, that's the former Kathy May, 6-4, 6-4. And Betty Stover, former Wimbledon runner-up, has beaten Anne Hobbs, Great Britain's number three, 6-love, 6-4, and will meet the winner of the match that's currently on number three court between Yvonne Cawley and Jenny Walker.
Connors to serve.
So Connors serving. Having broken the opening game by Stewart.
Love, 15. D,
First service.
Connors with his eye right on the ball there. That volley right out of the middle of the racket. Big heavy return of service there for a winner by Stewart.
Dave Connors. Two games to love. Connors leads first set.
Very heavy service from this 6'2" man who weighs just over 13 stone. It's fine service action, really throws the racket head at the ball.
Three games to love. Connors leads first set.
Well, Sherwood Stewart already experiencing the full barrage of these wonderful Connors ground strokes, which have earned him so many titles all over the world. And Sherwood Stewart, of course, as Dan Maskell has said, has had his singles wins. I mean, he's beaten St. Blair's as Borg, Fleming, Pfister, the man we saw here yesterday, beat him last year. But I think against somebody like Collins, it would be the very worst type of player he'd want to play, with these tremendous ground strokes. Let's look again at the way he lost the first service game he was having to play, and it particularly affected from this low angle too, to see how they both of them try to use the full width of the court. Beautiful dipping cross-court pass there from Connors, and he reads, both men reading each other so well here and covering so much court.
Quiet, please.
Connors just a little quicker in the end. So three love, Connors already, and looking very confident.
Love, 15.
Well, that wasn't any spin that was put on the ball by the server. That was rather a bad bounce. And the sun has been on the court now for 2 or 3 hours, and it's beginning to dry out in various places. Rally from both men playing from the baseline. The ball was definitely bouncing just a little higher than it was yesterday and previous days when we've had curtailed play. Shows the court is getting better all the time.
Advantage, Connors.
Of the great shots of Sherwood Stewart in doubles, that topped backhand when he goes through the middle of a doubles pair. But that time, of course, cross-court pass in the single, but beautifully played shot.
Ah. advantage, Connors. Game to Connors. Four games to love. Connors leads. First set.
I don't think Sherwood Stewart particularly enjoyed the smash of his opponent there. It didn't come out of the middle of the racket. He didn't say it was off the wood, but he's using the steel racket, but it was rather a mishit. So, love four, Stewart serving.
Second service.
All. That was a well-disguised pass. Very difficult to see where two-handers are going to play their shot anyway, but Connors disguised that one perfectly. Very close decision, I'm sure a correct one. King Connors was doubtful about it going out because he saw how early his preparation for the stroke was. So 15-40, two break points for a 5-love lead.
Game to Connors, five games to love. Connors leads, first set.
Well, now let's have a look outside because there's so much of interest going on outside. And here's the Mark Cox Ramesh Krishnan match, which is going on court number 13. Cox, having won the first set on the tiebreak, lost the second 5-7, is trailing now by 2-3 in the third set. Tremendous age difference between those two. Krishnan is only 19 and Cox will be 37 on Saturday week. Almost 18 years difference. Here's Buster Mottram out on court number 2 in a match that's just started. He's playing Nick Saviano of California. And Mottram's made a good start there, leading by 2-1. Now we go back to centre court.
So Connors serving to take a love set here.
15 love. First service. Ah. 30-15.
First double fault of the match. He's also served one ace, Connors. So two set points for the number three seed, Connors. No play.
And first set, Connors. Six games to love.
A pretty convincing set by Jimmy Connors there in 20 minutes. John Barrett was saying his opponent didn't have much chance of doing anything against it.
Second
number three
set.
Seed was playing really so well.
Quite pleased, Stuart,
I
sir.
Have a feeling that Connors will, the server, Stuart, will soon break the ice.
Love, 15. One fault. All.
Gentle finessing at one time in that rally by Connors, but it was all seen coming by the server, Sherwood Stewart.
Connors, with all voices. Connors leads by one game to love, second set, and by one set to love.
Well, John, all Connors at the moment, seven games in a row.
Looking every bit the number three seed this afternoon. And he's made no secret of the fact that he really desperately would like to win a second title here at Wimbledon. I mean, he's failed so narrowly on other occasions. One remembers the final against Borg, when he came surging back to four all in the final set and then lost it. And the match, of course, against Arthur Ashe in 75, when he lost after being overwhelmingly the favourite against an absolutely inspired performance from Ashe.
Connors to serve.
And of course they've played the first seven games, so there'll be new tennis balls. Six love, one love, Connors.
Love, 15. 15, all. Forty, fifteen. Game to Connors. Two games to love. Connors leads second set.
Connors playing as though he has a train to catch. He's back in position already, and he's rattling the games off like billy-o. Eight games in a row. Remember that in the past, Sherwood Stewart has beaten Borg and players of other great note.
First service. Love, 15. Love, 30.
Dan, I've just done a count, and Sherwood Stewart won only 4 points on his serve in the first set, and he's only won a couple in this.
Love, 40.
Sherwood Stewart taking his time about this one. He's number 40. He's got an awful lot to think about if he's going to get a score on the board at all, I think.
15, 40.
Oh, that's a tremendous Carlson shot.
Three games to love. Connors leads second set and by one set to love.
Let's go out to court number five. There's Kate Brasher, 17 years old, ranked number 10 in Great Britain. She's playing Dana Gilbert, 20-year-old Californian. Let's just have a look and see how she's going. One set all, and she's 3-4 down, but serving. So, Miss Brasher, giving a good account of herself there against the 20-year-old American. Now, on court number three, Yvonne Cawley, former Wimbledon champion. There she is. She's playing against Jenny Walker of Australia. And Mrs. Cawley's won the first set 6-2. Love one down in the second set.
Quiet, please.
Connors should serve. He's won 9 games in a row, which means he won the first set 6-love, and he's 3-love in the second. In the second round match.
Love, 15.
Sympathetic hand for Stewart, who really is up against a mighty Connors today, who's timing the ball almost perfectly.
Fifteen, 30.
Well, nice to see Connors smiling all over his face, but it was a beautiful lob, lovely, shallow, fast lob. Real attacking lob. Which one in the point? And that's in.
15, 40.
So 2 break points. Come on, Sherwood, somebody shouts from the crowd just near our commentary box. Well, he's got 2 break points to register his first game in the match.
Yeah. 30, 40.
Well played.
Game to Stewart. 3-1. Connors leads. Second set.
Well, that was a mighty fine game from Sherwood Stewart. Now, can he hold his service?
Fifteen, all. 15-30.
A lot of weight to pull up there, the Volvo head, just over 13 stone. So two break points.
Just a minute, please. Game to Connors. Four games to one. Connors lead, second set, and by one set to love.
So I'm afraid that was only a momentary triumph for Stewart, and immediately Connors breaks back, and that match clearly well in Connors' command. We're looking out at court 13 now. Mark Cox is playing Ramesh Krishnan, the young Indian. And Cox has just lost the third set. They were one set all, but now Cox is two sets to one down. There's confirmation of it. And he's had his service broken in the start of the fourth set by Krishnan. So Cox in a little bit of trouble now. Now let's have a look at Buster Mottram. There he is, playing on court number two against Nick Saviano, the 25-year-old Californian. That's still in the first set. And quite close. Mottram leading 4-3. But he does have a service break in his favour, Mottram. Well, there we are. We hope that won't last too long. We have reports from the Met Office that it should only be a passing shower, and that within the next half hour or so we may have a chance to get started again. It depends on just how wet those courts got, of course. Well, now, earlier on, you were watching the match on the centre court between Sherwood Stewart of the United States and the number three seed in the men's championship, Jimmy Connors. Now, if you remember, Connors went right through the first set without losing a game, won it 6-6, and then he stormed through the first three games of the second set, so he won 9 games in a row. Well, we're going to rejoin it now at the point at which we left you, and that point is where Connors is leading by 4-1 in the second set. He's a set to love up, and here he is serving.
Connors, sir. Connors is set up, 6-6 and 4-1 in the set.
Up. 30-6.
Court getting a bit drier in the actual on the singles court, but out in the tram line still a little bit greasy, still a lot of sap in the grass.
Ah! first service.
Oh, lovely shot. That's the shot that you see this tall man, Sherwood Stewart, used so well in doubles.
There's the Connors. Five games to one. Connors leads, second set.
It's a long time since I saw Jimmy Connors coming in behind the service as quickly as he's doing today. Keith McEnroe in May in Dallas in the WCT final, but I'm sure he wasn't getting in on that carpet court as fast as he is today.
Love 15. Fifteen. Five games to two. Connors leads second set and by one set to love.
And you might be excused for thinking that those two games against Sherwood Stewart's name were two service games, but in fact that was just the first service game he's won in this match. His other game was a break of the Connors serve in the fourth game of this set. Stewart, feeling the sun having gone in, feeling perhaps a little chill. His shirt's got wet, of course. And where he comes from, I'm sure it gets a lot wetter than it does here. Very humid in Houston. And there have been glimmers of better form from Sherwood Stewart, but really this entire match being played at the dictate of Jimmy Connors. He's laying down all the rules, and he's even finding time for a little bit of tomfoolery. All very good-natured. I think he knows he's got a clear-cut win under his belt if he just keeps working. 5-2 then, second set, Connors. Love 15.
It's often as difficult a ball as any, one coming straight at your tummy like that. Even Connors, who's moving like a dream, couldn't get out of the way of it to play the shot.
Forty-fifteen.
So two set points for Connors to take a two sets love lead.
Game and second set for Connors. Six games to two. Connors leads, two sets to love.
So that's it, 24 minutes. The first one, which we won at Love, was a 20-minute set.
Stewart to serve.
So three-quarters of an hour, they've been playing this second-round match, and Connors has been in the highest possible form. Stewart serving, third set.
Love.
In the first game, then, of the third set, and the score is 30-all. Sherwood Stewart serving. So a break point for Connors to take a 1-love lead in the third set, and I must say Connors has been playing in absolutely magnificent form. His timing has been exquisite. And his serving, I think, has been perhaps a little better than we've ever seen it in Wimbledon before. No, it's out.
Okay, for Connors. First game, third set. Connors leads, two sets to love.
Well, I must say, this match has really kept the crowd absorbed here, not because of the close competitive nature of the match, but the astonishing form of Connors, whose timing has been absolutely terrific, and his enthusiasm quite infectious. Pleasant to see the crowd here enjoying the sunshine. little fitful in the last 10 minutes, but it's been out most of the match. So here's the former champion, full of zest and enthusiasm. I must say, I think his service, which he's been working at this winter,
Connors to serve,
is in fact going better than I've seen it before, I think.
Quiet, please. Love, 15.
Sherwood Stewart, very, very much better doubles player than singles player, although he has victories over many big names, including Borg in singles. A great doubles player, seeded number two with Marty Riesen in the championship here.
Love, 30.
Second double fault, and when I tell you that Connors has been serving some of his second serves as strongly as his first and not using too much spin for control, you can see the confidence with which he's been playing. Yes, good call.
15, 30.
Well, what this court wants, of course, is hours and hours of continuous sunshine to brown off the grass a bit. Quite a heavy slide mark there. Well, it seems to be all right. Heavy slide mark under the net, but he's absolutely okay. But it's break point for Stewart. Has tried various tactics. He's tried playing the rally from the baseline, but invariably Connors gets to the net and finishes off with the volley. He's tried coming in a lot behind his own serve and in the rally, but he's been passed so frequently. So good has been Connors' passing shots.
Advantage, Stuart.
Break point for the second time. I was rather surprised Stewart didn't lob Connors then when he was hanging his nose over the net.
Advantage, Stewart.
So Stewart has break point for the third time.
Ah. First service. One game all, third set.
So the third set opens with a break of service by each man. Twice Stewart has broken the Connors service. And he held his own once. Serving with new balls. Just a little unlucky.
Love, 30.
First double fault from Stewart.
Love, 40.
Tremendous play by Connors.
Two games to one. Connors leads third set and by two sets to none.
Well, of course, Jimmy Connors, the number three seed, replies to the indignity of having his service broken by breaking again himself to love with the most beautiful touch on that last point. And really today he's playing with the same zest and enthusiasm that we remember from 1974, the year he won the title here. It's worth looking again, I think, at a rally we recorded earlier this afternoon. Beautiful throwing action on the serve, getting all the weight of the body into it, always on his toes, moving his feet, and look at the energy in those punishing ground strokes for which he's so famous, full of zest, so eager to move to the ball, getting the feet right all the time, the secret of good ground stroke play. Yes, in dynamic form indeed. Here he is back serving with a break again. 2-1, third set.
Thirty, fifteen. 40-15. Game to Connors. Three games to one. Connors leads, third set.
As Sherwood Stewart comes up to a serve, 1-3 down in the third set. They've been on court exactly an hour.
Fifteen, all.
Absolute classic forehand pass from Connors there, right on top of the bounce. Just out.
30-15.
Connors a little surprised, I think, there that his deep ball was called out, but it's just over.
30-all.
Low trajectory of this match has been something to marvel at from both men. To get the ball over the head of this 6'2½ man, Sherwood Stewart. No play. Played indeed.
Advantage, Stewart.
Very appreciative hand for the way Stewart stood up to that fierce bombardment at the net. Unfortunate, just out of your picture, Sherwood Stewart slipped rather badly.
Yes.
Couldn't recover. He was well outside the doubles line. Left rather a smudge on the grass. Still very green out there, of course. Unfortunate, he just couldn't get back. Deuce. Foot fault called.
Advantage, Connors.
And it's advantage to Connors. Connors leading 3-1 in the third set, having won the first two.
Game to Connors. Four games to one. Connors leads, third set, and by two sets to love.
Well, I wonder if before he came out this afternoon, Sherwood Stewart thought that he would win only one service game in the first two sets, and so far none in the course of this third. Jimmy Connors really in the most dynamic form. And we've seen some rallies of quite breathtaking power and precision. His game is a miracle of timing. He gets down to the ball so well, hits it so very flat, it has to be timed well. Beautifully concentrated there, and a wonderful punched forehand volley, an absolute copybook volley, taken out in front of him. No backswing, no follow through, just a punch. And of course he knows that he has the measure of Sherwood Stewart, and it's enabled him to relax and play very freely indeed. Beautiful sight to behold in full flight, Jimmy Connors. 6-love, 6-2, 4-1.
Thirty, 15.
Well, even when Connors couldn't make the clean pass, he still had his 6'2" man stretching, which forced the volleying error. No, we're playing.
40, 30.
Dream of a wrong footing shot there.
Game to Connors. 5-1, Connors leads third set.
So Stewart serving to try to stay in this second round match.
Quiet, please. Yeah. First service. Yeah. First service. Love, 15. Love, 30. 15-30.
Match points for Connors. Still match point. Well, that's unusual. I think it's almost the first time in the match that he's made two consecutive errors.
Advantage, Connors.
It's a match point for the third time.
Game, set and match to Connors, 3 sets to love, 6-2, 6-1.
Well, that was a pretty destructive job by Connors on Stewart there, conceding only those 3 games. Well, after that match, he came along to our interview studio, and there he talked with David Vine.
Jimmy, the first match didn't seem too much trouble for you.
I'm hitting the ball pretty well, hitting the ball very solid, and very eager to come here and to play again. But, you just take one day at a time and hope that each day as you go along, you hit the ball a little better and better.
How are you feeling this year?
Pretty good for me. Anyway,
what do you mean for you?
Well, every year you come and you try to be in the best shape possible, and you try to hit the ball as well as you can and be as eager as you can. And if you're in each way is okay, then you consider yourself lucky.
Last year was a very mixed one for you, wasn't it?
It was a difficult year for me, but that year is over, and this year is working pretty good for me so far. And I was lucky, had a very healthy little baby, and my wife was very healthy and so forth. So
how are they?
Very good.
They're here?
They're in town. Yeah. My wife comes out to wash, but my boy stays in town, and it's a little too hectic, too many people around, so I think it's better for him. Yeah.
How much interest does he take in tennis?
He picks up the racket quite often, he's swinging it around, you have to watch your knees and so forth, but he's 11 months old now, and it's up to him what he wants to do. If he wants to play tennis in the future, then I'll be there to help him. But anything he wants to do is okay. We'll be there to help him with that also.
What's he got? Good forehand or good backhand?
I'm trying to figure out if he's left or right-handed right now. I wish I knew. It's difficult. He throws and throws a ball with both hands, and he kicks with both feet, and he picks up the racket with both hands. But he's a lot of fun.
In the official Wimbledon program, it refers to the fact that a few years back you were and were called the finest tennis player in the world. And with records and everything else, now you've lost that title. How much does that mean to you? Because you guarded it very generously, didn't you?
Well, my career's not finished yet.
No.
I still have a few years to go, and that's why I said you just go out and you just try to play the best you can time after time after time, because that's what careers are built out of. And I've had a year off last year, and I've been concentrating and working much harder on my tennis this year.
You've come back pretty well this year.
Well, so far so good, but the year's only half over. I have to keep going at this pace and even a little bit better throughout the rest of the year now. And if I can continue to concentrate and continue to work and continue to do what I have over the past, 8 months or so, then things will work out.
I would never have thought concentration really been a problem for you, except for last year when you were about to become a father. And
I don't really concentrate fully, once I'm on the court, but it's the putting your mind to your practice and putting the mind to everything that you do before you go out onto the court. The actual playing the matches and so forth is really the easy part for me to to go out and to play matches and play in front of the people and to enjoy that. That's that's the gravy of the whole situation. But it's the practice and the putting your mind to working on one thing that needs to be worked on, and to do a little bit extra for me to make it possible. So I'm in great shape physically and mentally and prepared to play the matches. It's rough.
And trying to remember where you go next.
Well, that's a difficult part sometimes, you know. After a while, everything seems to just roll together, and you go from Wimbledon, then you go to the next tournament, then to the next tournament, then you work for the U.S. Open, and then once the U.S. Open is finished, you go to another tournament, then you go to the indoors over the winter time, then you prepare for the French, and then for Wimbledon. It's a nonstop rolling year with tournaments, and if you're not careful, it does. It does make it very difficult to find out where you're going next.
You talked about your concentration on and off the court. The great thing we always talk about with Bjorn Borg is his concentration. How do you think you compare in that sense?
Well, I'm not like that. I have to let out my emotions and make it possible to relax myself and to relieve my tension so that I can just go on and continue and play the next point. Everybody's different in that way. If he chooses to keep his in and to not let out any emotion, and if he smiles, then the people say, "Oh my God, he smiled." If I would go and not do anything or smile or not slap myself and say, "Let's go," or something, people would say, "Oh my God, what's happened to him here?"
You know, you wouldn't be Jimmy Connors.
Well, that's exactly right. So, what makes me tick doesn't make anybody, maybe different for everybody else.
Well, Jimmy, let's hope you tick this fortnight, and wish you a happy stay.
I'm working it. Thank you.
That's a pretty rare appearance by Jimmy Connors on our television screens. Very much more cooperative this year than last, because if I remember rightly, last year he wouldn't give a single television interview. Anyway, nice to see him smiling like that. Right, now let's have a look outside, excuse me, and see how it all looks. And it doesn't look too bad, does it? Because that violent hail and rain shower is over and the sun is out. But those courts outside are particularly wet because it took some time before they could get the covers on. And we have news from the centre court that having inspected the centre court, the opinion is that it will be certainly half an hour before they can begin play there. And they are at this moment assessing the rest of Wimbledon. Now let's have some results. Paul McNamee of Australia has beaten Robert Van het Hoff 6-1, 6-1, 6-3, and will meet the winner of Roscoe Tanner and John Fitzgerald.